Well, guys, it was bound to happen, but the Hino broke down. Oh, no. Oh, no. Anyways, oh, man, this thing is just disgusting. Look at all the dust and dirt on this. Living on a gravel road, I tell you, it's impossible to keep anything clean at all. Man, it's just impossible. Anyways, got a big day ahead of me tomorrow. Anyways, I went to drive this thing, and I went on a gravel road, of course, and I came to the intersection, and all of a sudden the truck like bounced up and down on the washboard, and anyways, as a result, the ABS light is on. So let's see here, got ABS light there. Man, that beep is annoying. I wish I could stop that beep. Anyways, so what you do here is, this is the way of the future to fix stuff. So you reach down underneath here and you go, let's see here. I didn't even know this was down here, but there's your port. Anyways, you press and hold this for 30 seconds, 3 seconds. Okay, and it will flash. Okay, 4, 2, 3, 4, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So it's gonna go 4, 4, 4, 4. So anyways, that's the code. It's 4 is the code. So it'll just keep on repeatedly go on and on and on until I let it stop. Until I shut the ignition off or I press and hold the button. Now pressing and holding the button for 8 seconds, pressing and holding it will make it, will clear the code. However, this is not going to clear the code, because we got to the bottom of this, and I'll show you exactly what happened. It's an unfortunate thing, but just one of those things that you have to deal with when you're living on a gravel road. So then what you'd have to do is, well, it looks like I have to connect to my charger. Anyways, you go to the website, and I just Googled it, and I put, what's going wrong here. So Meritor Wabco truck ABS. So anyways, you go through this, and it's kind of trying to go through the basic troubleshooting to tell you what to do. So you simply just follow the instructions, you have to determine what system you have, and then you can kind of go from there. So it kind of has the basics on how it works, and basically you've got your own ECU here. The guys are back here. I'm going to pull out of the way. Anyway, so you basically go through the instructional instructions on what to do. And these guys are working a late night shift tonight. Oh man. And let's see here. I was about ready to test the components of the ABS system to figure out what all was going to go wrong, like what pin was causing the sensor to go out. But anyways, by the flashing of the lights, I was able to determine that it was the right rear wheel speed sensor. So I checked the actual sensor and the wiring, and it looked good. So then we took the actual sensor out, because remember, these are pressed in. So I thought maybe this should just vibrate out with going over those washboards. But no, what happened is a rock lodged itself in there, and it got it just caused enough damage that it caused an open circuit, or not a circuit. If I went right here, the blink code diagnostics, and it's very brilliant the way it goes through it all. So anyways, it shows you the, what to do. The first digit, sensor short or open. And then it says, and since it blinked 4 again, it's left rear drive axle, driver's side. So yeah, got to the bottom of it. And that damage is what's causing the problem here. So I'm going to order a new one, and hopefully that gets me up and going. Because before it was saying it was 2-2, but it didn't seem to, we checked it and it didn't seem to be anything wrong with it. So anyways, at least this is new enough. It's got a part number that's legible. So I just went and called up an aftermarket supplier and seen if they can get me one. If they can't, then I gotta go to the dealership and buy one. And I would hate to find out the price of what they're gonna charge me at the dealership. But it's the cost of doing business, I guess. And it's the way of the future on how these vehicles are fixed. And nowadays, it's like one system affects the other system. See, I'm going 65 mile an hour, and I'm at 2300 RPM. So it's almost like the torque converter is not locking up on this Allison transmission. And that's because the brake system is not 100%. See, I got this on normal. I am pretty loaded up, but still here nor there, it still affects the transmission shifting, especially on takeoff. If I'm sitting at a stoplight and I hit the throttle, all of a sudden it'll just like jump forward. It just, all these systems work together. Yeah, it's a shame none of these aftermarket suppliers manufacture this part yet, but at least I got it. So yeah, it was a dealer only part, and unfortunately it was he gave me a bit of a break on it because I had to wait, but yeah, it's under $100, let's put it that way. So basically, you gotta have what you gotta have to make the trucks work properly. Okay, so basically that sensor got replaced, and let's see what we have to do here. So all we do here,
I'm not going anywhere yet.
Okay, can we retest it real quick?
Yep.
Just hit left signal first and then right signal.
Okay. Okay, so basically what you gotta do is you gotta press and hold the ABS button for 8 seconds. Press and hold it. And then it flashes really fast.
What?
So basically, yeah, you press and hold it for 8 seconds, and then the ABS light flashes a bunch of times really fast. Anyways, and then I just drove. I just put it in drive and then drove, and then it ended up just clearing the code by itself. So it was most definitely the problem. I was glad that it was as simple as that to fix, and just wish it didn't cost so much, but that's the way it is. There's no aftermarket suppliers yet for parts for these trucks, for that at least.